we really don't know about Siddhartha. We are familiar with Buddhism, we are familiar with Buddha, but there are things that what we really don't know about him. Buddha is commonly known as Siddhartha Gautama. Siddhartha Gautama, most commonly referred to as the Buddha, the awakened. He was a wandering ascetic and a religious teacher who lived in South Asia during the 6th or the 5th century BC and founded Buddhism. According to Buddhist legends, he was born in Lumbini and what is today Nepal to a royal parents of Shakya clan, but renounced his home life to live as a wandering ascetic. Buddhists believe after leading a life of mendicancy, asceticism and meditation, he attained nirvana at Bodh Gaya in what is now India. The Buddha then wandered through the lower Indo-Gangetic plain, teaching and building a monastic order. Buddhist tradition holds he died in Kushinagar and reached Parinirvana, that is the final nirvana. According to Buddhist tradition, the Buddha taught a middle way between sensual indulgence and severe asceticism, leading to freedom from ignorance, craving, rebirth, and suffering. His core teachings are summarized in the Four Noble Truths and the Noble Eightfold Path. A training of the mind that includes ethical training and kindness toward others, and meditative practice such as sense restraint mindfulness, dhyana, meditation proper, and the concept of dependent origination, emphasizing the impermanent and interconnected nature of all things. About two centuries after his death, he came to be known as the title Buddha. His teachings were compiled by the Buddhist community in the Vinaya. His codes for monastic practice and the Sutta Pitaka, a compilation of teachings based on his discourses, these were passed down in Middle Indo-Aryan dialects through an oral tradition. Later, generations composed additional texts such as systematic treatises known as Abhidharma, biographies of the Buddha, collections of stories about his past lives known as the Jataka Tales, and additionally discourses, that is the Mahayana Sutras. Buddhism spread beyond the Indian subcontinent, evolving into a variety of traditions and practices. The Buddha is recognized in other religious traditions such as Hinduism, where he is considered an avatar of Vishnu. His legacy is not only encapsulated in religious institutions, but in the iconography and art inspired by his life and teachings, ranging from an iconic symbols to iconic depictions in various cultural styles. First, let us know that what Buddha actually means. Buddha means the awakened one or enlightened one. It is the masculine form of Buddh, means to awake, be awake, observe, heed, attain, learn, become aware of, to know, be conscious again, to awaken, to open up as does a flower. One who has awakened from the deep sleep of ignorance and opened his consciousness to encompass all objects of knowledge. It is not a personal name, but a title for those who have attained Bodhi, means awakening, enlightenment. Buddhi, the power to form and retain concepts, reasons, discern, judge, comprehend, understand, is the faculty which discerns truth, that is Satya, from falsehood. The name of his clan was Gautama. In Pali, it is called Gotama. His given name Siddhartha, the Sanskrit form, the Pali rendering is Siddhartha. In Tibetan, it is Dongrub. In Chinese, Zhiraya. In Japanese, Siddhartha or Shittata. In Korean, Siltalta, means he who achieves his goal. The clan name of Gautama means descendant of Gotama. Gotama meaning one who has the most light, and comes from the fact that Kshatriya clans adopted the names of their house priests. While the term Buddha is used in the Agamas and the Pali canon, it is the oldest surviving written records of the term Buddha is the most middle of the 3rd century BC, which several edicts of Ashoka mention the Buddha and the Buddhism. Ashoka's Lumbini pillar inscription commemorates the emperor's pilgrimage to Lumbini as the Buddha's birthplace, calling him the Buddha Shakyamuni. Buddha Shakyamuni, Buddha, sage of the Shakyas. Shakyamuni means sage of the Shakyas,
with the term Tathagata.
Tathagata is the term the Buddha commonly used when referring to himself or other Buddhas in the Pali canon, which I already explained. That is, Pali canon is the oldest text. The exact meaning of the term is unknown, but it is often thought to mean either one who has thus gone, that is Tathagata, one who has thus come, that is Tathagata, or sometimes one who has thus not gone, that is Tathagata. This is interpreted as signifying that the Tathagata is beyond all coming and going, beyond all transitory phenomena. A Tathagata is immeasurable, inscrutable, hard to fathom and not apprehended. Next off, epithets, which are commonly seen together in canonical texts and depicts some of his perfected qualities. Let's see, like Bhagavato or Bhagavan means the blessed one, one of the most used epithets together with Tathagata. Samma Sambuddho, it means that perfectly self-awakened. Vijja Karana Sampano, this means that endowed with higher knowledge and ideal conduct. Sugata, well gone or well spoken. Lokavidu means knower of the many worlds. Anuttaro Purisa Dhamma Sarathi, which means unexcelled trainer of untrained people. Sattadeva Manussanam, which means teacher of gods and humans. Arham, which means worthy of homage. An Arahant is one of the taints destroyed who has lived the holy life, done what had to be done, laid down the burden, reached the true goal, destroyed the fetters of being and is completely liberated through final knowledge. And lastly, Jina, which means conqueror. Although the term is more commonly used to name an individual who has attained liberation in the religion Jainism, it is also an alternative title for the Buddha. The Pali Canon also contains numerous other titles and epithets for the Buddha, including All-Seeing, All-Transcending Sage, Bull Among Men, The Caravan Leader, Dispeller of Darkness, The Eye, Foremost of Charioteers, Foremost of Those Who Can Cross, King of the Dharma, Dharma Raja, Kinsman of the Sun, Helper of the World, Lokanatha, Lion, Siha, Lord of the Dhamma, of excellent wisdom, that is Varapanna, Radiant One, Torchbearer of Mankind, Unsurpassed Doctor and Surgeon, Victor in Battle, and Wielder of Power. Another epithet used at inscriptions throughout South and Southeast Asia is Mahasramana, Great Sramana, or Ascetic Renunciate. Then found out, if you're interested on the beautiful story that I'm saying right now, you will be stunned to know that on the basis of philosophical evidence, Indologists and Pali expert Oscar von Hinüber says that some of the Pali suttas have retained very archaic place names, syntax and historical data from close to the Buddha's lifetime, including the Mahaparinibbana Sutta, which contains a detailed account of the Buddha's final days. Hinüber proposes a composition date of no later than 350 to 320 BC for this text, which would allow for a true historical memory of original intended of origin of the events approximately 60 years prior if the short chronology for the Buddha's lifetime is accepted. But he also points out that such text was more as hagiography than as an exact historical record of events. And rock inscriptions where no written records about Gautama were found from his lifetime or from the one or two centuries thereafter. But from the middle of the 3rd century BC, several edicts of Ashoka mention the Buddha and Buddhism. You know, particularly Ashoka's Lumbini pillar inscription commemorates the emperor's pilgrimage to Lumbini as the Buddha's birthplace. He called him the Buddha Shakyamuni, the sage of the Shakyas.
Another one of his edicts mentioned the titles of several Dhamma texts. Dhamma is another word for dharma, establishing the existence of a written Buddhist tradition, at least by the time of the Maurya era. These texts may be the precursor of the Pali Canon. Sakamuni is also mentioned in a relief of Bharhut, in relation with his illumination and the Bodhi tree, with the inscription Bhagavato Sakamunino Bodho, the illumination of the blessed Sakamuni.